Well, you know, I'm away from her for days, and then I get back here just in time for her to be wheeled into surgery. I didn't get a chance to just hold her a little bit, you know?
That's right. Taking forever. It just seems like forever.
Now, I have faith that the operation will work this time.
Yes, it will.
Well, look, as long as we've got to wait, why don't you tell us about what happened down in Florida?
Yeah, that's a wonderful idea. Must have been quite an adventure.
Yeah, it was, you could call it an adventure, all right. It was,
crazy. Absolutely crazy. Insane, in fact. And, we went. We're back. We're glad. And that's it.
That's it?
Yeah, the police, you know, it was crazy of us to think that we could help the police find Eve. They didn't need our help at all. They found her just fine. And, so, here we are, you know, going on that trip for nothing. We would have been better off just staying home where we belong.
Is it true? We're gonna be a family again?
What your dad means, sweetie, is that he and I will always be your family, even if we're not married anymore.
Okay?
Right, John?
Of course.
Hey, is this yours?
Yeah. Joe gave it to me. He knows everything about baseball. He has a million cards, too.
A million, huh?
You should see him sometime.
You know, in Greece, we play soccer. I was about your age when I started.
Soccer's cool, too.
But in America, it's baseball.
Yeah.
Will you teach me?
Sure.
He needs to take it easy.
Yeah, well, Neil's been very sick, and I think we should make sure he's ready before he starts circling bases.
Of course. Well-being comes first.
Speaking of well-being, how about some lunch?
Yeah, sounds good.
Okay, well, would you three all-stars go use your talents in the kitchen, please? I need to speak to John.
Why can't I stay?
Well, that's because your father's never had one of your killer sandwiches, and I don't think we should deprive him that experience, do you?
This is true. Lead the way.
I want you to leave.
That's my intention, love. I'm taking you and Neil with me.
This is worse than waiting out that hurricane.
Worse than the snakes.
Well, not to mention the gators.
Alligators?
Snakes?
And you know how we hate snakes.
Change the subject. We were gone quite a while. Did anything happen while we were gone?
Well, I know this isn't exactly the best time, Lucy, but,
Wait a second.
What do you mean?
About Serena?
No, it's not about Serena. It's about Brenda Barrett, Lucy, she was killed in an automobile accident.
I don't believe you. No, not my Brenda. No, I don't believe you.
Oh, Lucy, we're so sorry.
Lucy, we know how fond you were of her, but...
How?
The car went off a cliff, and her mother was in it as well, and they were both killed.
I got to get to Jax. Oh, my God.
Lucy, wait. Just listen. Are you okay? Come on.
Calm down. I'm not okay. No, I'm not okay. I got to call Robin. I got to call Jax. I got to go.
Karen, what happened here, okay?
No complications.
Okay?
Yes, everything went really, really well.
Okay. Oh. Well, when will we know if the transplants worked?
Dr. Erton is on his way down to fill us in.
Okay.
Went really well.
Okay.
There's the doctor. Dr. Whitoff.
The cornea sutured in place perfectly. We're cautious, but optimistic.
When will we know if it worked?
Tomorrow, when I remove the bandages, we will have an idea.
When can we see her?
She'll be in her room shortly.
Good.
Well, shouldn't we wait a while before we all barge in on her?
She will be a bit groggy, but the best medicine a child can have is the support of a loving family around her.
Your son had cancer and you were absent, and now all of a sudden you come back and you want me to believe that you give a damn?
Turning my back on our family was the worst mistake of my life. I hurt Neil and I hurt you.
Good. Good. I'm really glad you realized that. But we have no interest in being hurt a second time. Leave. Leave now before Neil gets too attached to you again.
Please. Courtney, understand. I need you too. I only left you because of my ridiculous ego. I know that now.
Well, that's the first honest thing you've said since you've been here.
When you told me Neil wasn't my child, I felt betrayed. My pride took over. Now, instead of standing by you like a man, I became a jealous little boy.
He has missed you every single day.
I hurt you. And I'm going to spend the rest of my life making that up to you and to Neil.
I doubt the damage done to Neil can ever be repaired.
At least give me a chance. Now, you saw how happy he was with me. He wants his father. He needs me and I need him.
He does. Seem happy with you.
I want you back too. And we were good together. We just hit a rough patch.
We didn't hit a rough patch, John. We got a divorce. It was ugly, and now it is over.
Not for me. I've missed you constantly.
If you really want to prove how much you care, drop the custody suit.
Done. If you'll come back to me. Now think about it. I don't expect you to give me a decision this minute. If you give me another chance to be a real husband and a father, you'll never be sorry.
Don't remember if my dad likes mayo or mustard.
You know, he looks like a mayo man.
Yeah, mayo man.
Yeah. I'm sure he's gonna love whatever it is if it comes from you, Neil.
Yeah.
There you go, buddy. All set. Careful.
You're not buying that creep story, are you?
Not for a minute.
I'm sure he was in there giving Courtney his best no job.
I wouldn't worry about Courtney, Frank. She's not stupid when it comes to Neil. She's not going to let this guy persuade her.
We'll see.
Well, I'd like to believe this guy for Neil's sake, Frank. A boy needs a father.
We did without one for most of our lives, and we didn't turn out too bad.
Could you imagine what a difference it would have made if Dad was actually around instead of drunk half of his life?
Would have been different.
It just ticks me off that this guy shows up out of the blue and somehow thinks that makes him a father.
And Neil still thinks he's great.
Yeah, well, I think fathers can do whatever they want and kids still somehow see him as gods.
Yeah. I like Julie. Bennett Devlin was a rotten man and a rotten father, and yet she still worshipped him for most of her life.
Is there any news on the trial?
No, went into a holding pattern after Scott disappeared. Lee was pretty destroyed.
It's nice to know that this kind of father still exists, huh? Look, let's just hope and pray that John Canelo surprises us, Frank, and he turns out to be sincere instead of turning Neil's world upside down.
Hello, applesauce.
You did us proud again, Serena.
Yeah, hey, Bunganhead, you sure did. You know, the doctor said you were super-duper trooper.
That's because I was knocked out.
You are so brave, but you're also Miss Smarty Pants.
How you feeling, sweetheart?
Fine. Will I be able to see now?
Well, we'll know just as soon as those bandages come off.
Send me good vibes, Lucy.
Buddy, there's a gazillion vibes coming your way. Hey, do you think you should be up and at him? Maybe you want to rest and store up some of that energy, huh?
No way. I just woke up. I want to hear about what happened to Daddy and you when you were away.
Well, that's a bit of a roller coaster ride. Are you ready for that now?
I'm ready.
ready.
Okay, then. Well, you remember when your dad let you watch that Raiders of the Lost Ark movie, and I didn't think you should watch it, but you got to watch it. Okay, well, Indiana Jones had nothing on your dad.
Thank you. Well, you know, Wonder Woman got nothing on Lucy. We had to face snakes, and you know how we hate snakes. But not even a squeak out of her.
Well, and we also had to face these nasty smugglers, and there were these alligators, and then this fire, and this tunnel, and dust, and a hurricane, and then this mansion thingy, and you wouldn't believe it. We were handcuffed together, me and your dad, and he broke them up with one fell swoop of a big axe.
And you know what? We would have done other things, anything, to get home to you.
Cool. I don't know whether to laugh or lie down.
Oh, I gotta go. Remember all the good stuff of the story so you can tell me later, okay?
Okay.
And you know all that praise you got about being brave and strong? That's all really true.
Thank you, Sam, for staying with me.
Catch you later, Fishy. Don't ever do that hurricane fire smuggler thing again, Mr. Indiana Jones.
Next week we're gonna do Die Hard. I'm just kidding.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye, Karen.
Well, now that the world is halfway back together, I'd better check on my client. Trial will be resuming soon.
Well, I'll walk out with you. Sweetheart, you get some good rest, okay?
Okay, Grandma. I will.
Bye, honey.
Bye, Grandpa.
Lee, how's Eve?
I haven't seen her. Julie's my client, you know. I've hardly had time to see her with all that's been happening.
You know what? That face never looked so good.
Thank you.
We're glad you're home, son.
Thanks.
Bye.
Bye.
More.
More?
More? You want more?
I want to hear more about what you did in the mansion.
The mansion? Okay, well, we were wet, storming wet from the rain, and there was just this hurricane, and then our clothes got soaked, and so we really needed something else, and your dad found this trunk of old clothes, and it was kind of like playing dress-up. We acted really sort of silly, but fun.
My heart that pounds beneath my flesh. It's my mouth that pushes out this breath.
May I join you? I can come back later.
Oh, no, Kevin, please stay. I was hoping you'd be here. Stay. Stay. Stay, please.
He swore he'd be here.
Karen? Is something wrong?
Joe never showed up. He was supposed to observe Serena's surgery with me. I was counting on him.
Well, maybe he had an emergency.
I'm sure he wouldn't have just forgotten. Something important must have come up.
My compliments to the chef.
You like the red pepper part?
No, the red pepper part is perfection. Courtney, you should try this.
I'm not hungry.
Dad, that's what she always said. You just watch. By the time we get back, the whole thing will be gone.
Hey, where are you going?
My room. Dad wants to see it. Come on.
I will not let this happen.
You should have run when you had the chance.
No, Frank, running isn't the answer. Courtney, you need to work this out for Neil's sake. Look, maybe this guy has really had a change of heart.
Yeah, he's smooth. He's really smooth.
I almost started to believe in myself, but this voice in my head kept saying, wait a second, Courtney, not so fast.
I don't understand something. How does this guy even have a legal leg to stand on? Don't you have custody of Neil?
I have physical custody. We share legal custody. Which means John can make decisions about Neil's education, religious upbringing, health.
Health? Health? His decision on that was to run away.
True.
So where does he even get off suing for custody?
It is all my fault. I was just so anxious to get the divorce over with. I got this lousy lawyer and I agreed to just about anything.
Such as?
If I moved, I was supposed to give John 60 days written notice and get his consent.
But you didn't do either.
No, I'm afraid not.
So basically you're in breach of your divorce contract.
Which means John could relitigate the whole divorce.
Serena's surgery. I have to get to Karen. Do not do anything drastic while I'm gone, all right?
The longer they're up there, the more I worry. If I know John, he is probably just worming his way back into Neil's heart as we speak.
There's something about John Canellos that I can't put my finger on. Something bothers the hell out of me.
Yeah, he has that effect on people.
My offer still stands. If you want to get yourself and Neil out of here, you say the word.
Thank you. But the more I think about it, the more I realize Joe's right. If I keep running, John will just keep finding us.
What did he say to you while we were in the kitchen?
He said he was sorry and he wanted to make up for all the pain he caused.
You believed him?
It's hard to excuse that he walked out on our marriage, but I wasn't exactly the model wife either.
You never walked away from your kid when he was sick.
No. But I was the one who disappeared with Neil after the divorce, Frank.
Something about this whole thing doesn't add up.
You're right. It doesn't. First, John sues for custody, and then he turns around and he says he wants me back.
So you tell me, Courtney, what is going on between you two?
Well, the trick is to hear the music in your head and then find it on the flute with your fingers.
It sounds like magic.
Music can be magical.
I can't wait to try.
Well, maybe we can learn to play at the same time and we'll make magic together.
Sounds nice. Thank you, Kevin. Lucy, can you see the flute?
Yeah, I can see that flute. And it's beautiful.
I'm so happy we're all together.
Well, I'm just happy that your surgery's over with.
Karen told me that you went to look for Daddy and Lucy. Is your trip as exciting as theirs?
No, I'm afraid not.
Hey, let me take a look at this flute here. You know, as a kid, the only thing I was a whiz on was the harmonica.
A whiz on a harmonica?
Yeah, and I sure play a mean triangle thingy-dingy thing.
He plays the piano. Hey, we can have a band.
Yeah, that sounds swell to me.
Does this mean you all stop fighting?
No more fighting.
I wish Tom always started that you would all come home safe, and you did. I wish that you would all stop fighting, and you did. Now I'm wishing that Kevin and Lucy will get married. Will you please?
So before I get on my knees and apologize, please tell me that Serena's operation was successful.
It went very well.
It's a relief. I know with Serena being in the amblyopic age range, it was important that it went well.
It was tough watching the procedure, knowing the impact it could have on the rest of her life.
I'm sure it was.
I wish she had been there with me.
Me too. But there was some trouble. Neil's dad showed up.
At the house?
Yeah. Believe me, it surprised the hell out of all of us.
Oh. That's all my fault. If I hadn't ever called
Karen,
him about
listen,
Neil,
it is not your fault. It's not your fault. Your intentions were good, and it's all under control. I just didn't want to leave Courtney alone with him, that's all.
He's still there?
Yeah, Frank is there, keeping an eye on him.
That's good. Are they managing to be civil to each other?
Yeah, Courtney's showing admirable self-control.
But that's good, at least. Neil should be concentrating on being a kid again, you know, getting healthy, not on his parents fighting.
I agree. Listen, Karen, I'm so sorry. I hope you forgive me. I really wanted to be there for you for Serena's operation.
I understand. I'm just glad you're here now. All right. Does it seem like they've been up there an awful long time?
You want me to go check on them?
Tonight, following a new episode of The Drew Carey Show. If you're losing your hair and trying to date, fret no more. The secret to success is revealed in a hilarious new Secret Lives of Men. ABC, tonight,